Hey, thank you for coming by Tori Magoo 44. Today's January 2nd, 2015, and we're into a new year. I wanted to share this with you. I had a conversation with someone a few nights ago, and it really, really amazed me. You have to know that for me, because I have epilepsy early on, I got into Scientology in 1969. By 1970, 71, I think I had joined their C organization, which is their top group of people that are working there 24/7, right? And I joined them. I was out on a ship doing, ship training and all this stuff. And I ran out of my medicine. And I said, look, I need my medicine for epilepsy. And they sent me to the MLO, which is the medical liaison officer. And some of you guys have heard this story, but I might have something, I am going to have something new in it that you haven't heard. Anyway, so they send me to the MLO, and the MLO says, oh, we're the C organization. We're the top 10% of the planet. And no, you can't take medicine. We're going to put you on vitamins and minerals and Dianetics, Modern Science of Mental Health by L. Ron Hubbard, right? And no problema, right? And I'm like, really? And I start their program and start having grand mal seizures. It gets worse and worse and worse. Now, what's the basis of this? This is a whole booklet on all kinds of things, but he basically talks about the reactive mind. He says you have two minds, the analytical mind and the reactive mind. The analytical mind is like a computer taking in information. He says the reactive mind is something that stores moments of pain and unconsciousness, right? And then as other things come around that remind you of it, it triggers it and you get upset, you yell, you cry, you have missed emotions, right? And but the ironic thing is that the end phenomena of Dianetics back then was that you were supposed to go clear. And a clear was a person back then originally with a perfect memory, a perfect IQ, no somatics, and no pains, right? Which I've yet to meet a clear, a real clear with that. Now they've changed the definition because nobody has that definition. And so they've changed the definition many, many times. But anyway, he says, what does this mind, the reactive mind, do? It shuts off hearing recall. It places local circuits in the mind. It makes people tone deaf. It makes people stutter. It does anything and everything that can be found in any list of mental ills, psychosis, neurosis, compulsions, repressions. What can it do? It can give a man arthritis, pruritus, asthma, allergies, sinusitis, coronary trouble, high blood pressure, and so on down a category of psychosomatic ills, adding a few more which are never specifically classified as psychosomatic, such as the common cold, right? And then he goes on and on and on this, but that's just to tell you he's talking about, Dianetics will fix these things, right? And now here we are. I got this in 69, this book, right? They're still selling it to this day. Now, this guy tells me a few days ago, you won't believe it. They've completely changed. And I say, well, what exactly have they changed? And he says, well, now you can't have, like I said, what about if you have high cholesterol? Oh, no, you can't have high cholesterol and be on the FLAG land base. The FLAG land base is in Clearwater, Florida. He said, if you have anything, high blood pressure, a cold, these kind of things, you have to get off the base and fix it, and then you can come back on and get auditing. And why is that? Because I said, what about AO, which is here in LA? Oh no, you can go to AO and get auditing, but you can't get on the base. Well, what happened at the base? Lisa McPherson was there at the base in the late, I believe it was the late 80s, early 90s, around there. And basically flipped out, went out onto the street, took her clothes off, got into a little accident, took her clothes off. The cops came, took her. She was trying to get to Morton Plant Hospital. Scientology came and said, no, we get her. She's our member. We're taking her. They locked her up in a room for 17 days. And you can look up lisamcpherson.org and read all about it, see photographs, everything. Anyway, from that point, I mean, she ended up dying 17 days later. They took her, and it shows a map of how far they drove away when there was a hospital right next to Fort Harrison. You know, they didn't have to do that. So for me personally, it was just totally amazing because I had fought them for 30 years regarding taking medicine for epilepsy. And now they have this, you know, just anything. You're not allowed on the flag land base. And it just was amazing to me that they're selling to this day Dianetics, modern science of mental health. I asked him, he said, if someone flips out and they become mentally ill, they say, keep them in the mental institution, leave them there. They're 100% against mental institutions and psychiatry. They're 100% against it. They have their Citizens Commission on Human Rights, which is a bunch of bullshit, basically saying they're against psychiatry and medicine of many kinds, including epilepsy, which isn't a psychiatric medicine, per Dr. Dank, who is L. Ron Hubbard's doctor. You know, but the hypocrisy just goes on and on and on. So I just wanted to tell you in 2015, to any of you who might be seeing them saying, oh, get this book, Dianetics, why? Why would you get it? When they are even admitting Dianetics isn't going to fix anything. They don't have anything that can fix anything, really. Not anything. I gained 100 pounds. Would they help me? No. I lost 100 pounds because of Weight Watchers. I never got an ounce of help from Scientology on it. Never. Not ever. And the truth is, if you want help on anything, go to a library or a bookstore and look under self-improvement and just look through books. You'll find something you like and start reading them and using them. It's amazing. And it's way cheaper than Scientology and much less of a hassle. So there you go. That's my 2015 story and update on Scientology's absolute insanity on medicines and physical illness. And there you go. They're trying to be a church and far, far from it. So I love you guys. There you go. I hope you have a wonderful weekend.